Hello and welcome to Good Times, and we finally got hold of someone very special. Well, Shweta Bachchan Nanda, as you said, you have been pushed out of your comfort zone, and good to have you, because usually you are the kind who likes to hide in the wings. So MXS, so please tell us, what is the essence of MXS?
MXS is Monisha and me, and it's our luxury print collection, and it's fun clothes, street fashion, but wearable, but luxurious fabrics, fantastic intricate embroideries, embellishments, fun design. So it's having fun with fashion, and you know, as Monisha always says, we're trying to bridge the gap between Zara and Gucci, and we want to fit in somewhere there and give the modern woman, whether she be 20 or whether she be 40, something fun to wear and enjoy.
And also, you've been always associated with Abu Jani, you know, always seen you wearing their creation since you were, you know, since time immemorial, as I would say. So collaborating with Monisha, and then...
Monisha and I actually did a... it was a friend's birthday, and we actually, you know, I went to her and said, I really need this fun bling outfit, and will you please do it for me? And she did, and it turned
actually,
out really well. And
actually, let me tell you, this fun bling outfit, you know, was actually something that she had in mind and she visualized. And, you know, she just came to me and said, like, you know, can you convert it into... like, you know, into, like, you know, reality. She said, you know, this is what I have in mind, and, like, you know, what do you think? I said, yeah, let's just do it, because it sounded really cool. And so then I made it for her, and she was the most glamorous person at that party, yet the most comfortable person at the party, because she wore it with her trainers, and it was just this very beautiful beaded pantsuit. And it's just the way she wore it. I mean, like, she got so many compliments. I mean, she was definitely the belle of the ball. And let me tell you, there were people in evening gowns and short dresses. And oh my God, it was something else. But she still stood out.
And also, I see your daughter has modeled a lot of these creations. Did you take her suggestions?
Well, as I've said, she, you know, a lot of people ask us if she's our muse. And we always say that all girls are our muse. We would want our designs to appeal to all girls, but Navya was home for the holidays when we were shooting our campaign, and she was just a free model for us, and we took full advantage of her. And every time I tell her to do something, she says, well, I modeled for you, now what do I get back in return? So I've been sort of making up for that ever since. But input in clothes, she actually really liked everything we were doing. You know, every now and again, when I was very excited about something, because this is new for me, and, you know, just to see something go from paper to sketch to actually up on a mannequin here for you to touch and feel, it's so exciting for me. And, I, you know, of course, she's my daughter, and we share fashion tips, should I buy this, should I buy that? So I would send them to her, and she'd be like, wow, mom, I love this. And I felt so great that, you know, I'm in my 40s, and I'm being able to appeal to a girl who's in her 20s. So.
You called yourself a late bloomer, and also everybody thought that you would actually, you're working on your book, which is going to be out soon, so everybody thought that you take the writing legacy forward, your grandfather. So how come suddenly fashion?
Monisha, are you going to take this one?
Yes, I'll take this one. Well, I think that, you know, she's always been a clothes horse, right, which is what everybody knows. It's her personal style and everything, and I think what it is with her is that she's got, you know, she's got so much knowledge as to how to wear a garment, how a garment should fit, how much shine should be in the garment, and like, you know, where, like, you know, which part of the body, like, you know, should it be cut. And so, like, even though, you know, her knowledge is not actually a trained knowledge from a fashion school, she's got this innate talent in her to recognize luxury, to recognize finish, to actually pay attention to detail. And that's exactly what, you know, what I saw in her. And I think that's exactly what everyone sees in her, and that's how she turns out the way she is. So effortlessly, you know, glamorous, and yet so well turned out.
And you're like, you know, you're known for your resort collection, boho chic, and essentially Mumbai. You have managed, you know, basically you've been traveling between the two cities, Mumbai and Delhi. So how would you define the fashion here, the fashion sense? Because Mumbaikars like to say that Mumbai is cooler. Delhiites would like to say, yeah, well, we also know our fashion. So how would the two of you define the fashion in the cities, these two cities?
Delhi really enjoys their luxury a lot. And they're not afraid of you know, bright colors, bling. And I think they enjoy that space a lot. Bombay is a little more laid back, a little more casual. But they know their fashion very, very well. So that's the only difference. I mean, both cities have some fantastically well-dressed women and, you know, so.
And also your family is very, very well turned out. So who is that one member in your family that you want to design for now?
My brother.
Any particular reason, so?
Well, he's actually quite wacky and bohemian.
I was actually driving here, and he's in Delhi for his own promotions for his upcoming movie, and he called me and he said, best of luck. I said, thanks. And I said, best of luck to you as well. And he's like, have you checked your Instagram? I've DM'd you a jacket. So I said, oh, what jacket? I went and looked, and it was actually our MXS Flash Bomber.
Right.
He's like, I want that jacket. I said, it's a women's jacket. I'm like, he's like, make it for me now. I'm like, well, I'll get back and we'll think about
right.
it. He's like, what's the point having a sister? You can't make me this Flash Bomber. So I think I'll do that.
You also said that fashion should not be defined by age. And your mom said, is there something for her? Because she was rather concerned there might not be something for her.
No, there is actually. She's liked our Africa tunic. She's loved these pants. She loves the fabric of it. And she's liked our silk, you know, the print dresses. And she's actually really enjoyed this collection. I was nervous because, you know, she has such a keen eye.
She does.
But she said, I like your clothes, they're good. And she gave us a few tips also.
Right, she did.
Think about,
but they were good. No.
We plan to implement them in the next edition.
We should pick them up because I think she really does. You know, she was right. I think she's the one actually who actually has the most discerning eye. And it's actually her.
Absolutely.
Which I think is transcended. Yeah.
Sophia dress.
Yes, she did.
It's too long for me.
Right.
I really like it.
She did.
Also, so quickly, fashion to you is?
Fashion to me is my life. Well, actually, fashion to me is not just about clothes. It's about a way of life. And it transcends into anything, into your lifestyle, into your, you know, into your, like, you know, techno gadgets, into your travel, your clothes, of course. So fashion is just a way of life.
What about you?
For me, it's something to enjoy, but never really take too seriously and never really try to conform to. And always, you know, sort of trying to find your own happy mix from what you've been dictated to do, whether it's, you know, the way your body is or the way your hair is. You should always try and absorb things and then come up with your own original love.
And a fashion must have?
MXS.
I'm going to say that one.
And a fashion no-no?
I don't know. I think it's so subjective. Something that is a fashion owner for me,
exactly,
may not be one for
yes
her. So,
yes,
know,
so each to
woman,
his own, each to his own, yeah,
woman
definitely,
and what she can pull off, but yeah.
So what's Shweta Bachchan Nanda's signature style?
This lovely comfortable pair of pants, a lovely t-shirt with some fun blingy bits.
That's
going
her.
On
so I guess you got her fashion no-no. Fashion no-no is do not be uncomfortable in what you're wearing.
Yeah.
That's your fashion no-no.
Yeah, of course, completely.
And also, are you glad this was the right time to do everything, or do you feel that I should have done it earlier?
No, it's the right time. Absolutely the right time with the right person, the right team. And
yeah, our team has been very good, actually. Actually, it's just not us, it's the team, because, you know, we work, like, you know, together with the team. So that's very important.
And it's a very, there are a lot of women in that office. Most of us are women, and it's wonderful. We all work together, and everyone's so driven, and they're all young. And
so it's girl power all the way.
Yeah, it's girl power all the way.
Girl power all the way, indeed. And now your book's coming out. Would you want to tell us a bit about that?
Well, we'll talk about
that's
that
in October, no?
Yes, it's next month. Yes. And we'll talk about that when I'm more ready with it.
But it's good to have you now suddenly in the spotlight, because you're the kind who's just like avoided the glares and the, you know, as you could say, the press and the paparazzi as much as you can.
I'm actually very shy and uncomfortable with all this, and I'm more than me, I would like, you know, our MXS creations, and all to be in the spotlight.
But you know how it is with, like, you know, creativity. Like, you know, when you're a creative person, you can use that in so many areas. So, you know, as you just said, that, you know, she's done fashion and then she's, you know, coming up with a book. But it's all about creativity, and that can be used in so many areas. So if you have that in you and you want to use it, you know, with all your passion, so that's exactly, I guess, what she's done. She's, you know, shown it in fashion, and now she's about to show it in her book.
Absolutely, and more power to you. Thank you so much for talking to us, and we're looking forward to the collection.
Thank you so much. Thank you.